Right now we've got Sean Murtagh. He is a CNN producer on the telephone right now. Sean, what can you tell us about what you know?
This is Sean Murtagh. I just was standing on the Vice President of Finance.
Sean,
Vice President of Finance for CNN.
Sean, we're on the air right now. What can you tell us about this situation?
Hello?
Yes, Sean, you're on the air now. Go ahead. What can you tell us?
I just witnessed a plane that appeared to be cruising slightly lower than normal altitude over New York City, and it appears to have crashed into, I don't know which tower it is, but it hit directly in the middle of one of the World Trade Center towers.
Sean, what kind of plane? Was it a small plane, a jet?
It was a jet. Looked like a two-engine jet, maybe a 737.
You're talking about a large passenger commercial jet. Yeah. This just in, you were looking at obviously a very disturbing live shot there. That is the World Trade Center, and we have unconfirmed reports this morning that a plane has crashed into one of the towers of the World Trade Center. CNN Center right now is just beginning to work on this story, obviously calling our sources and trying to figure out exactly what happened, but clearly something relatively devastating happening this morning there on the south end of the island of Manhattan. That is, once again, a picture of one of the towers of the World Trade Center.
Well, you can see these pictures. It's obviously something devastating has happened. And again, unconfirmed report that a plane has crashed into one of the towers there. We are efforting more information on this subject as it becomes available to you.
Right now, we've got Sean Murtagh. He is a CNN producer on the telephone right now. Sean, what can you tell us about what you know?
This is Sean Murtagh. I just was standing on the Vice President of Finance.
Sean,
Vice President of Finance for CNN.
Sean, we're on the air right now. What can you tell us about this situation?
Hello?
Yes, Sean, you're on the air now. Go ahead. What can you tell us?
I just witnessed a plane that appeared to be cruising slightly lower than normal altitude over New York City, and it appears to have crashed into, I don't know which tower it is, but it hit directly in the middle of one of the World Trade Center towers.
Sean, what kind of plane? Was it a small plane, a jet?
It was a jet. Looked like a two-engine jet, maybe a 737.
You're talking about a large passenger commercial jet. And where were you when you saw this?
I am on the 21st floor of 5 Penn Plaza.
Did it appear that the plane was having any difficulty flying?
Yes, it did. It was teetering back and forth, wingtip to wingtip, and it looks like it has crashed into probably 20 stories from the top of the World Trade Center, maybe the 80th to 85th floor. There is smoke billowing out of the World Trade Center.
Sean, what happened next? Does it appear to you that the plane is still inside the World Trade Center?
From my angle, I'm viewing south towards the Statue of Liberty and towards the World Trade Center. It looks like it is embedded in the building. I can't see from my vantage point whether it has come out the other side.
Sean, what about on the ground? Or any debris that has hit down there? Can you see
my vantage point is too far from the World Trade Center to make any determination of that.
Did you see any smoke, any flames coming out of the engines of that plane?
No, I did not. The plane just was coming in low, and the wingtips tilted back and forth, and then it flattened out. It looks like it's hit at a slight angle into the World Trade Center. I can see flames now coming out the side of the building, and smoke continues to billow.
Well, generally, is that a traffic area in New York for aircraft?
It is not a normal flight pattern. I'm a frequent traveler between Atlanta and New York for business, and it is not a normal flight pattern to come directly over Manhattan. Usually they come up either over the Hudson River heading north and pass alongside the island of Manhattan, or if they're taking off from LaGuardia, they usually take off over Shea Stadium and take off. Gain altitude around the island of Manhattan. It's rare that you have a jet crossing directly over the island of Manhattan.
Just for our viewers who are just tuning in right now, you're looking at a live picture of the World Trade Center Tower where, according to eyewitness Sean Murtagh, he is a vice president of finance, an eyewitness to what he describes as a twin-engine plane or possibly a 737 passenger jet flying into the World Trade Center. It appears to be still embedded inside the building. Sean, are you in a position right now to hear whether any sirens are going, any ambulances, any sort of response to this yet?
Not from my vantage point. I'm probably a mile and a half, 2 miles from the World Trade Center.
It is a remarkable scene as we're seeing right now. Flames still coming out of the windows, black smoke billowing from what appears to be all sides. Obviously, windows shattered and steel jutting out from the structure
and
right
Sean,
now.
And Sean, once again, we're looking at these pictures. And
I
you're
see
telling
them in
us,
my office. I have them on all my TVs.
And you're telling us you believe the plane is still remains embedded.
I can't tell from my vantage point.
All right. Sean, thank you so much
thank
for your
you
eyewitness
much.
Account. We are going to join another one of our New York affiliates, WABC, for their live coverage.
Plane overhead, and then all of a sudden I thought it sounded kind of louder. Then I looked up, and all of a sudden it smashed right dead into the center of the World Trade Center. Big flash of flame, fire coming out from all over. Then all the bricks is a huge hole right now. It almost looked like the plane probably went through. I'm not sure.
Winston, can you see? Are you on the north side there where the plane made contact?
Yes, I am.
Now, when you say a huge hole, one of our earlier witnesses, Libby Clark, said not much of the plane came down off the building. Much of it
went
right
totally into the building.
It's in the building that, from what you can see.
Right.
Now, can you see if there's a lot of debris downstairs, Winston?
No, because it looked like it inverted with the impact. Everything went inside the building.
Inside.
The only thing that came out was a little bit of the outside awning. But I'd say the hole is, let me just get a better look right now.
Okay, go ahead.
I'd say the hole takes about, looks like 6-7 floors were taken out. And there's more explosions right now. Hold on, people are running.
Winston,
hold on
just a moment. We've got an explosion inside.
The building's exploding right now. You got people running up the street.
Okay.
Hold on, I'll tell you what's going on.
Okay, just put Winston on pause there for just a moment.
Okay, the whole building just exploded some more. The whole top part.
Okay.
The building's still intact. People are running up the streets. Am I still connected?
Winston, this would support probably what Libby and you both said, that perhaps the fuselage was in the building that would cause a second explosion such as that.
Well, that's what just happened then.
That certainly.
Yeah, people are running up.
We are getting word that perhaps.
Okay, hold on. The people here are, everybody's panicking.
All right, Winston, let me put Winston on hold for just a moment.
Okay, I don't know how much longer we're staying. I'm inside of a diner right now.
Well, Winston, you know what? If you could give us a call back, I just don't want to panic here on the air. Let's just take some of our pictures from News Chopper 7. Now, one of our producers said perhaps.
Looks like 6-7 floors were taken out. And there's more explosions right now. Hold on, people are running.
Hold on just a moment. We've got an explosion inside.